Good evening. We are going to look at lifting machines, which forms part of the statics module. Okay, there are three of them. It's the lever, the simple lever, the wheel and axle, as well as the single rope pulley system. Now we won't look at the simple lever. We've already done that when we did moments. We will do a lesson on moments later on. Today we're just gonna look at the simple lever. No, not the simple lever. We're gonna look at the single rope pulley system as well as the wheel and axle lifting machines. These two machines you will look at even at N2. When we finish today's lessons, you will know what a machine is, you will know the three qualities that I use to evaluate a machine, and you will also be able to sketch each of the two machines. You will be able to solve problems using equations on lifting machines. What is a machine? A machine is a device with which forces are applied in order to do work. So that's how you define a machine up to N3. It's a device with which forces are applied in order to do work. There are three quantities that we use to evaluate a machine. Those quantities are mechanical advantage, velocity ratio or displacement ratio, as well as efficiency. So mechanical advantage, we use the symbol MA. What is mechanical advantage? It's the ratio between the load lifted and the effort applied. And what is velocity ratio? Velocity ratio is also called displacement ratio. So velocity ratio has the symbol VR and displacement ratio is the symbol DR. It is the ratio between the effort distance and the load distance. So as you lift an object, the force that you apply will have to move a distance, and the load that you're lifting will also move a distance. So velocity ratio or displacement ratio is the ratio between those two distances. The distance moved by the effort versus the distance moved by the load. What is efficiency? Efficiency is the ratio between output work and input work. Okay, and let us look at the equations that we use. So that is the equation we use to calculate mechanical advantage, is L over E, where L stands for the load in newtons and E stands for the effort in newtons. In most cases, they give the load in kilograms. You must first convert the kilograms to newtons, then you can divide it by the effort, which will also be in newtons, to calculate your mechanical advantage. And then velocity ratio is calculated using that formula. Velocity ratio is the effort distance over the load distance. Just see to it that your distance are both in the same unit. If they are in meters, it must both be meters. If it's millimeters, it must both be millimeters. They mustn't mix up. Okay. Efficiency is the ratio between output work and input work. And that is a formula we use to calculate efficiency. Is mechanical advantage over velocity ratio multiplied by 100%. Now the 100 you press in when you do your calculation, but the percent you drop it as the SI unit, you don't put it in your calculator. These are the two machines that we are going to look at, the wheel and axle lifting machine as well as the single rope pulley system. Now each machine you must be able to sketch and also be able to work out problems using the equations that will be given. Now, the wheel and the axle lifting machine, the most important thing there is to show the wheel as well as the axle. So I'm gonna show you how to sketch that machine. You must show the wheel, and then you must show the axle. Then you must label the machine. Capital letter D is used to label the diameter of the wheel, and small letter D is used to label the diameter of the axle. Okay? Then your load will be lifted. Then you must show how the ropes go around, because they use the ropes. Show how the ropes go around. You must show this correctly. Then it goes in here and it comes out there, down. So this is the effort, E, and this is the load, F. This is where the load is lifted, and this is where the effort is. So you pull down here by the effort. So this is how you stretch the wheel and axle lifting machine. Okay. Two equations that you use for calculations. Mechanical advantage is calculated by load over effort. Just remember that the load must be in newtons or kilonewtons, and the effort must also be in newtons or kilonewtons. It must not be in kilograms. Then to calculate the velocity ratio for this machine, you use the formula capital letter D over small d. Okay, we're gonna take an example just for this machine to see how to apply what we have just learned. Let's look at that example. That example says that in a wheel and axle lifting machine, an effort of 150 newtons is needed. So the effort is 150 newtons is needed to lift a load of 600 newtons. The load is 600 newtons. The wheel's diameter is 250 millimeters, which is the capital letter D, is 250 millimeters. And the diameter of the axle, small d, is 50 millimeters. First question says, calculate the mechanical advantage. Okay, the formula says mechanical advantage equals to load over effort. Mechanical advantage equals to load over effort. What is the load? It's 600. What is the effort? It's 150. That will give us 4. So the mechanical advantage will not have SI units because newtons cancel out with newtons. Then you don't have SI units. Then the second question says you must calculate velocity ratio. The formula to calculate velocity ratio for this machine is big D over small d. The big D is 250, the small d is 50. 25 over 5 will give us 5. Velocity ratio also does not have SI units. Okay, now for the next video, we are going to look at the single rope pulley system. Thank you.